done with it. As you can see, this is my collage I started of my grandmother. My passion project for her, because she has passed away for 25 years now, and her birthday is coming up next month, so I decided to do something special for her. And maybe for more people than just her, but this is the start. Do a collage, which has some of her favorite things in it. She used to really love flowers and gardening, so that's why they have some in here. This is an old handkerchief. She used to always have handkerchiefs as another element. Obviously her face, some leaves, and trees. She used to like to go work in the garden and in nature. And there's a call that the sewing pattern in here. She used to like sewing and knitting, so that's why that comes in. There's a little bit of moss I found, just for adding a little more of the nature feeling. Put that all down, and now I'm going to put some encaustic on it to put another layer on top. Just kind of seal it. I'm going to put more paint and some more elements into the encaustic. And it dries. Thickens. First, I'm gonna go this way. Boomy afternoon. It was really sunny for a while, and now the clouds are coming. That's probably gonna make it stick, but that's okay. I'll unstuck it. Just trying to cover the whole piece in encaustic, which is melted wax and what else is in there? There's two components to it. This piece was sort of inspired by Ivy Newport. She likes doing multimedia pieces and collages with encaustic. So we'll enjoy her lessons. And but I'm doing my own spin on it. And I could probably at some point do some client work with it. Probably yeah, a great idea to remember and never forget the loved ones. So I'm gonna let that dry. It's getting a little darker. I don't think you're gonna do more layers. I might fix some holes if there are some, like here, but and then I'm gonna add some more colors to it a little bit on the top. I There's a lot of holes in it. Oops. Face it. I love encaustic. It's got this nice, smooth surface. Need some more here. And then we're gonna use the torch to kind of melt it together. I'll stick that back on after. It's not enough. I think it needs some more there. It's really cool that you can. Oh, there's some loud bubbles here. So we can smooth it out a little bit. there. I'm gonna put this on a thread through it, I think. Let's see. So my grandmother used to love knitting and knit many sweaters and socks and whatever for me. I decided to do a little bit of hand knitting and put a heart on my collage to commemorate that fact. Thank you. gotta be careful, it's really hot. Not quite finished obviously, but I'm working on it. It's like the second kind of step to it. The third step is gonna be using some paints and glazes and stuff on top of it. Smells good actually. I like the smell of wax. Make sure you have the windows open when you do this, if you ever do it. Unlike me. There you go, my grandmother, when she was like, how old was she? 40 years ago, like around 50. Not quite 50, like my age now. Leave it at this, I guess. And wait. Let's see what's dried. There's all over the edge. I think so, yeah. Need to do some last minute, not last minute, but the end, some fixing. It's pretty much covered anyway. Okay. I'm gonna leave it like this till it gets hard, and then tomorrow I might work on it again. Thanks for watching. Bye guys.